Welcome to Advent of Tessellations 2023. I'm Madonna Yoder, and I hope you will join hundreds of origami folders around the world in folding this daily challenge to increase your origami tessellation folding skills, so the twists and repeating patterns folded all from a single sheet of paper. On day 22 of Advent of Tess, we are introducing trapezoid twists, which is something we're going to continue using through day 25. So we're going to start with the exact same start as yesterday, as days 4 and 5, and then we're going to put trapezoids around it. So grab your grid and let's get started. The first thing I'm going to do is put in a dot in the center so you can see which side I'm on, because today's piece is again the same on both sides, just like yesterday, and this will help you keep your bearings. Then I'm going to have a mountain one space away from the center. I'm going to have a valley one space away from the center, and you guessed it, I'm going to have a mountain one space away from that valley. So this is how I think about setting it up, whether I'm drawing it on or not. Got the mountain one space away from my corner, which tells me where the center is. My valley also coming one space away from the corner. Mountain above that. And these are going to put out a third direction of mountain and valley, and we can squash our closed triangle twist. Then, holding on to these two pleats that are going around the center, I'm going to flip the paper over so I still have those identified, and I'm going to take one of them and put in a closed triangle twist at the densest possible spacing. So my target grid intersection where the three mountains are coming together is one space out from the closed hole. And I'll do the same with the next pleat, the other one that's going around the center, one spacing out from the closed hole. I'll split that mountain into three directions and squash my new twist. Flipping back to the front side, I'm going to take the top of the stair set of pleats, one spacing out from the closed hole. I'm going to set up a three-way intersection of mountains, and the mountain running down towards the next pleat in the stairs, I'm only going to run two spacings, so that a valley coming from the closed hole can cross the mountain that's coming in, because one spacing out from the closed hole, I'm going to likewise split the mountain, and I'm going to have another three-way intersection for the triangle wrap going around the mountain from the top of those parallel pleats. Now, this is something that I've explained a little bit slower in yesterday's video and in days 4 and 5. So if you need a refresh on that, go check out those videos. Then I'll flip over and resolve that triangle wrap into a closed triangle twist. And in case you're following along with the crease pattern, I'll come back to the front side, at least front as observed by the crease pattern. And what I'm going to show you is looking at this folded piece. How can we tell what to put where? Well, I've got the pleat coming from the closed hole in that central cluster, and then a pleat on either side of it. And then if we follow the grid line for that central mountain, it carries through. And this is something that might not be super obvious, that this turn is actually going straight in the unfolded form. But if you look at your crease pattern, you'll see the mountain coming in the middle of the three single depth pleats is on the same grid line as the mountain going out on the double depth pleat, because that's what's going on here. There's actually going to be two grid spacings between the mountain and the valley on the far side of the trapezoid twist. And that's because this edge of the trapezoid is twice as long as the other edges, so the pleat depth needs to be twice as much. And so we can use that information here by saying we're using the same spacing that we used yesterday. We're going to have our valley two spaces away from the valley under this triangle. And likewise, our mountain over here is going to be two spaces away from the mountain under here. But the difference this time is that we're following our mountain from our central of these three single depth pleats, following that out and putting a valley two spaces above. So let me draw that on. I've got this mountain, and it is much harder to draw where a mountain is on paper floating in the air. You've got to press on it. We've got this mountain going all the way out. And then two spaces above, we're going to have this valley line that's going to sit tucked away. And we're going to squash from the top, just like we do with the open hexagon twist. And once we have one trapezoid, just like yesterday, we're going to flip over, look for the friendly pleat overlap, and go to that one next. Now, one thing I want to point out, that trapezoid that we just folded is what I call an open trapezoid twist, because there is a more closed option. Even though we see that slit on the back that reminds us of a rhombus twist. So the slit on the back for the rhombus means that it's closed, but for the trapezoid, it's actually open. So coming in here, we need to see where to add our next pleat, because it's not like the hexagon. We're not adding all six. We're just adding one more single depth and then having our double depth to resolve it. And the thing to remember is that the pleat coming from the triangle on the opposite side is the middle of the three. So I'm going to open up, run my third single depth pleat back under this corner of the triangle, and then follow my grid line for that mountain of the middle pleat and set my valley two spaces away. It's really the only place that it could go to resolve. And I get my trapezoid twist in place. Then I'll flip over and repeat again. It's going to look different because this twist is the opposite handedness. But again, I have my new pleat going under the corner of the closed triangle, causing a pleat overlap. And then I'm following the mountain from the middle pleat, setting up that double depth pleat and squashing. Flipping over, I'll do it again. And this time, as my pleat goes through, I do have more layers out here. That is not a problem. And I can set up and squash. And notice how I'm leaving this kind of 3D. I don't have to really press those layers and potentially distort my grid lines. And then flipping over, I'm doing the same thing over here. And we actually have a new trick this time. We don't have to fold through this trapezoid twist, even though the mountain's coming right to the corner. We can just let the valley deepen underneath. So the blue line's where the valley was, and then we can put the valley one spacing further without folding our trapezoid twist in and out. We can let that float above. And squash that twist. And just like we did with the hexagons, I can go ahead and rearrange my pleats from up here. So that was reordering. Instead of having the pleat from the triangle continue through, have the valley from the first trapezoid break the mountain of the triangle. And notice I've got three sides of the outline of an open hexagon hole. And that's the stage where I want to leave it when I go to the other side. This time I already have all three of my single depth plates. I just need to follow the mountain of the central one and set up the valley with that double depth plate. And we're there already. Ta-da! We have our new piece, and the ways that I finish this, I call dancing pyramids. It's the densest way. It has exactly these repeating then on the other side. So this double depth pleat connects to this double depth pleat. You can also stick a triangle, a double depth triangle of whatever kind of triangle you want on there. And that one I call knotted pyramids. And then there's parachutes, which has a mixed depth hexagon twist, feeding off of the double depth pleat. But that's a subject for the variations video. Tomorrow we're going to use these trapezoid twists again, but we're going to have a hexagon twist in the middle. So happy folding, and I'll see you for the next one.